everybody! My name is Melissa and welcome back to my writing channel, Hopeful Happenings. Today, we're talking about how to become an illustrator for picture books. Now, there are two ways to illustrate books, and the first would be that you illustrate your own book. I would only recommend doing this if you actually are an artist, but in this scenario, you would create a dummy, which is the text and your projected illustrations for your picture book or graphic novel, and then you would send this dummy to agents or editors, just as any other author queries, you would query with pictures as well. Now, I'm not going to get into how to create a dummy today because I want to talk about the other way that you can illustrate picture books. And this would be illustrating books that are not your own, or rather, being an illustrator for hire. Now, first, I want to give you a little insight into how it works when an author and an illustrator get together to create a book. The author in traditional publishing does not get to choose the illustrator. That is the publisher's job. And when creating the book, the author and the illustrator don't even collaborate. They hardly talk at all. Really, the only information you'll be sending to the illustrator to tell them how you want your story illustrated is going to be put in an illustrator's note in the text. And an illustrator's note is only necessary if the illustrator would not be able to understand what is going on in the image without it. For example, if the text read, James went to bed, but the image is actually him sneaking out a window, then you would need to put an illustrator's note there. But you would not need to put an illustrator's note if James actually went to bed, because that's in the text and the illustrator can get that. So if you're an artist looking to be an illustrator for publishing, that's probably some good news to hear. The author does not get to tell you how to illustrate the book. You'll each have your own separate space to be creative. Okay, you're an artist, you want to get into illustrating books, but where do you start? First, create a portfolio. Show all of your best work, your signature style, and some other ways that you've been creative. Number two, show off this portfolio. You'll want to create a website. Just like authors, it's important to have a website even before you've published anything, because this is what agents and editors are going to look at. You'll probably also want to get onto social media and do some blogging or Instagramming where you can upload more frequently. Instagram is especially good for illustrators. Not only can you represent your work there, but you can also meet other illustrators who may be going through the same thing. Number three, join SCBWI. This is the Society of Children's Books Writers and Illustrators. The reason I'm recommending this is because SCBWI is like the Children's Center for Books. And probably like 99% of the books that get illustrated are for kids. Being a part of that organization is going to give you a lot of benefits, including connections. You're going to meet other illustrators and authors. You're also going to meet agents and editors. There'll be classes you can attend at conferences, and if you're a member, you can have a free portfolio on the illustrator gallery of the website. Great exposure here. Number four, enter contests. I do know, since we were just talking about it, SCBWI does have a lot of contests for illustrators. Pretty much every time they have a contest for a writer, they're probably also going to have one for an illustrator at the same time. But there are other places that give awards for illustrations. So find these contests. Enter these contests, as many as you possibly can. Hopefully you'll be able to put on your resume that you were a finalist. If not, I guarantee you're gonna grow a lot from the experience and just get better each time. If you do become a finalist or a winner of a contest, can you imagine how much that would boost your credibility as an illustrator? It would definitely put you in the sights of important people. Number five, pick your publisher. Do your research and figure out which publisher you actually want to work for. Typically, you will send a postcard to the art director at the publishing house. These postcards are basically giant business cards. They have your contact information on there. They have your website, right? Because you already have a portfolio online. but they also will feature a few of your pieces right on the postcard itself. Pick the best of the best, and if you won an award, put the award-winning illustration on the postcard and mention that it won an award. Much like querying for authors, you'll have to submit to the publishing house and then just wait for them to contact you if they're interested. There you go. Those are 5 steps to becoming an illustrator for a publishing house. Was something in the video that surprised you? Do you have any questions? Let me know in the comments below. I post once a week on YouTube and I post daily on Instagram, sharing more tips there and giving you insight into my debut, Sea of Kings. So stay safe. We'll see you next week. Bye.